Hi, you guys. I know I haven't been on in a while, but today I am coming to you with a hair review from Virgin Bella Hair, and I am wearing the Cambodian Body Wave. Three bundles in my head. The first bundle is 18 inch, and the other two bundles are a 16 inch. And I'm basically this will be a 1 month and a half maybe initial hair review. So first I would like to say to the owner, thank you for allowing me to win the contest. That's how I got the hair, win the contest, and just be able to experience your hair and to be able to make a review. This video, basically I'm going to tell you the specs of the hair and everything that I've done to it and how it's come along so far. So first thing we're going to talk about is the basics of the hair. First, I said this is three bundles. There's an 18 inch and two 16 inches, and from a certain extent it reaches to the bottom of in my lower back. That's how long my 18 inch is. I dyed my hair. I hope you guys can see that blonde. And this is how my ends look. They're not that bad. They look a little bit dry because I need to actually wash my hair. It's about that time. Wash my hair, condition, and all that good stuff. But so far, it's my hair minimum shedding. Minimum to no shedding. I did not seal my wefts at all. I took the hair and originally used it for a half wig. In my other two videos about the hair, I had a half wig that I made with the same hair, but I decided to take the wig and make it a U-part because this will be my first U-part that I made, and I think I did a pretty good job as far as like following all the basics of what you do, what you don't do, how to sew the hair, all that jazz. Tangling wise, I do not get any tangling. As you can tell, I do not get any tangling. And I don't have any snags. For the most part, how do I sleep? Even though today you guys see my hair straight, even though this is a body wave, I do, for the most part, flexi rod my hair. And what I do before I even flexi rod each part of my hair, I take a squirt bottle, spraying bottle, and I take my motions. I don't know. Oh, it's over there, but I don't want to get it. I take the motions, setting lotion, and some warm water, put it in a spray bottle, shake it up, and then just spray it each section while I'm rolling my hair. So, I will show you a picture of what it looks like at the end of the video with the hair being flexi rod and, flat ironed and all this other stuff. But for the most part, it's basically straight. And the luster, it is a very, very, very low luster. The thing I would like to say about the hair is after I dyed my hair, it still maintained the same amount of shedding, or maybe less, but my ends are kind of dry. So I will say, if you decide to dye your hair, rather if it's all the bundles are halfway, or just the tips, or make it like streaks, no matter what it is, I will say to deep condition your hair, like, consistently. And I was playing with it and just trying to make layers in my hair and always watching different people's videos of how to do this, of how to do that, I got a feel that virgin hair is what it's supposed to be. It's not processed, not chemically processed. And it's supposed to just basically, you're supposed to make, you know, you're supposed to have that type of hair. And not only that, but you're supposed to have that and be able to keep it for a long time. Especially if you're paying, I don't know, say about $2,000 to $1,000 worth of hair. Rather it's a RPG show wig or your regular weave. I mean, you're supposed to, it's supposed to actually be that, and it's supposed to maintain. And I will give VB Virgin Bella Hair 2 thumbs up. Now, I also could say that it blends well with my hair. This is my hair. Okay. This is my hair. That's how long my hair is up top. And then when I just brush it back, it blends in. I mean, of course, my hair is not black. It's like a brighter brown. But as far as like texture wise, it does blend very well with my hair. But I really can say that I really enjoy this hair. I really would recommend this again. I would recommend somebody to get this hair. And a lot of people, in comparison to their prices and some others, I will say that they're not on the very expensive side, but then they're not on the real cheap side neither. I have experienced the minimum, very minimal shedding, even after I dyed the hair. I thought it was going to break off. I thought it was going to shed like crazy. I didn't know what it was going to do. And that's what I am here for, to come to you with reviews about certain things, rather it's makeup, rather it's hair, rather it's wigs, rather it's anything. Because before you try it, I will, and vice versa, before I try it, I will want to see how it worked on you. And not everybody, I mean, now and then I will say people get bad bundles. Like for instance, one of the 16 inch bundle, some of the wefting in certain sections, some of the wefting was not neat at all. Not at all. So I really think I pointed that out when I was saying that before. People ask me, oh, well, since you work for the company, or since you do this in the third, you know that you're going to get good bundles. Not exactly. Again, I've had quite a few gray hairs in my bundles. Referring to this now, I've had a couple of gray hairs in my bundles. But that wasn't nothing that I could not fix. I could easily just take it out. The wefting, I made sure I just went over it a couple of times, and not just like my single loop like I normally do with all my tracks. I also, even though I didn't seal my wefts, I still was able to work with the wig that I had, even when it was time to change it from halfway to a U part. And not only that, but this is a learning experience for me, because I didn't know anything about virgin hair. I didn't know the upkeep. I didn't know what to do with it. I didn't know what not to do. I didn't know if you bleach your hair, you bleach it and that's it. You can't just downtone this. You're going to get something, another color or something like that. I didn't know that virgin hair lasts a long time in comparison to beauty BSS hair. I didn't know that stuff. So this, I really enjoyed this hair. I am going to keep wearing this hair until I get tired, until I feel like I just need to take it out and wash my hair and do all the other stuff. But in the meantime, I'm going to leave it in here. I actually just tightened up around my perimeter and around my head just to tighten it down some more. But other than that, I really enjoy this hair. I love the color, especially after I dyed it. Oh my gosh, you should have seen me. I was just flawless. I really love this blonde. I really do. My hair is doing fine, so if you want to purchase some hair, I am going to put the email account below because we are still getting our new website ready and set to go. But we also have, real quick before I finish, tomorrow is the 10th, and from the 10th to the 15th is basically the pre-BOGO Black Friday sale. So it's back again, and you buy one bundle, you get the other bundle free. And the second bundle, you can either get it the same length as your first bundle, or you can get it shorter. As well as on the 15th, at 11:59 p.m. on the 15th, that's when the sale stops. But if it gets too hectic, and hopefully we get the website up, so everybody can just go straight to the website, order their hair, and keep it moving. But last time we had the BOGO sale, a lot of girls got on the website, and they were ordering hair, and it crashed. Because it was such an overcapacity for just that website. So, in the meantime, I will give you the email address for you to order your hair. And keep you posted. If you follow me on Instagram, VBHair_IL, means Illinois, you can follow me on Instagram. You can follow me on Twitter, Morgie Shines, the same way as the YouTube name, exactly how it's spelled. Facebook, I do have a Facebook. I will put that down below. And I don't have a Tumblr. I never use the Tumblr. But, yeah. But if there are any more questions that I have not answered about the hair, if you want to see how I dyed the hair, or if you want a tutorial on, I know there's a lot of U-part and ombre effect tutorials out there, but everybody does theirs different. So if you would want to see how I did it to get this look and to achieve this color, then hey, let me know. You know, inbox me, comment below, like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. And a lot of people sit up here and say, oh, well, dark-skinned girls can't wear blonde. You know what? Through the camera, I don't look all that dark. But in real life, I am dark. And for some people out there to say, oh, well, dark-skinned girls can't wear bright colors, or dark-skinned girls can't wear blonde, or dark-skinned girls can't even wear blonde on their head. Hello? Look what I have in my hand, and it's fine. It is fine. You see that? Do you see that? Fine. So I'm not even gonna go into that. I'm not even worried. I have no worries, okay?
Reintroduction to a feeling I don't wanna know. Yeah, I've been running, but it caught me somehow. The rule was never fall in love, I did it anyway. You make my